I am Dr. Rajesh. I am going to teach you the chapter number 3, that is consumer behavior and utility analysis. So let us understand the meaning of the word consumer, and then we will understand the meaning of the word behavior. Behavior. And then we are going to understand the word analysis. So for example, if you buy chocolate for yourself, then you are a customer and you are also a consumer, because you are the buyer and you are the consumer. But suppose you buy a chocolate for your brother, then you are a customer and your brother is a consumer. So a customer is a person who buys the products, and the consumer is a person who consumes the product. So clear about the customer and consumer. Now the second word is the behavior. So what is the behavior? Behavior means whenever we go to buy something and we go on buying till we get satisfied. So if our satisfaction is more, we buy. If our satisfaction is reducing, we don't buy. So we have to understand the satisfactory behavior of the consumer. And the next one is the utility. Utility. Utility means satisfaction. Utility does not mean usefulness, not equal to usefulness. For example, if somebody will offer you water and diamond, you prefer to take diamond and not water, because diamond gives you more satisfaction. It's not that a diamond is very useful to you. In fact, the water is more useful than diamond. You cannot live without water for a few days, but you can live without diamond for your entire life. So in terms of usefulness, water is more useful, but people prefer diamond because it gives more satisfaction. Another example is cigarette. For example, cigarette. So if a person is smoking a cigarette, it does not mean that the cigarette is very useful to him, but cigarette gives a satisfaction, a mental satisfaction it gives. So this is all about the consumer behavior and utility analysis. Now there are mainly two theories of the consumer utility. First one is a cardinal utility analysis, and the second one is ordinal utility analysis. Cardinal utility analysis is a old theory or a classical theory, and ordinal is a modern theory. This cardinal theory is given by Alfred Marshall, and this theory, ordinal theory, is given by Hicks and Allen. In cardinal theory, we are giving numbers, or we measure the satisfaction in certain kind of number, like for example 15, 20, 50, 100, 70, 700, like that we give the number. And here we are giving the rank, that is first rank, second rank, like that. Now under the cardinal utility analysis, there are mainly two type of theory. For example, when you are going to buy only one product. So when you are going to buy only one product, there you have to apply DMU, that is diminishing. Diminishing means reducing, marginal means extra one, and utility means satisfaction. So the meaning of the DMU is, when you go on buying the same product again and again, then what is going to happen? Every time you are going to get a less and less satisfaction. The second one is equi-marginal utility. Here the number of products are two or more than two. When the products are two or more than two, then we have to apply equi-marginal utility. Now, as I said, utility means total utility. Now, for example, let us suppose you are buying one water bottle, and if you are very thirsty, it will give you a satisfaction of, let's say, 50. Then you will buy second water bottle. Now in second water bottle, you will get the satisfaction which is less than 50, that is 30. And when you buy the third water bottle, it will give you 20. When you buy fourth water bottle, it will not give you any satisfaction, so it is zero. And when you buy the fifth water bottle, which you really don't want, so it is minus 10. So this is how the MU or additional or extra satisfaction is always going down, and then it becomes zero, and then it becomes negative. Now 50, in the second bottle you get a 30, so your total is coming 80. Again from 80 you purchase the third one and give you 20, so 80 plus 20 is 100, and then 100 and you get nothing, so 100 plus 0 is 100, and 100 and you lose 10, so it is 90. So your total utility is increasing in the first stage, and then it is little bit decreasing. But it cannot, TU cannot be zero or negative. Whereas MU becomes a zero and negative, and it is always reducing. So for now, let us take some of the exercise. DES means the satisfying capacity of the commodity. So utility is the satisfying capacity of the commodity. Total of all utilities, total means TU. DES utility means additional utility. Additional means extra, and extra means marginal. In economics, instead of speaking additional or extra, they speak marginal. DES utility can be zero and negative. Marginal utility becomes zero and negative. DES utility can never be zero or negative. Total utility cannot be zero and cannot be negative. DES utility as downward graph, marginal utility is always going down, and then zero and negative. So the correct answer is marginal. DES utility goes upward and remains same, and finally falling down. So total utility is going up, and then it remains same, and then it has gone down a little bit. So it is called total utility. DES utility goes down, then becomes zero and negative. So it is marginal utility. DES utility when increasing, when total utility is increasing, marginal utility goes down and becomes zero and negative. For example, if this is the table which is given it to you, and you will be asked, for example, you will be asked to prepare the total utility from the total utility of X. Now, marginal utility of X, X means you can name any product. For example, if you say X is equal to apple, so marginal utility of apple. Somebody will say X is equal to banana. So marginal utility of banana. So instead of writing the name of a product, we are writing X, Y, and Z. So marginal utility of X is 50, 40, 25, 10, 0, and minus 10. Now if you want to find out the total utility, so what is the beginning? It is 50. 50 plus 40, it is 90. 90 plus 25, it is 115. And 115 plus 10, it is 125. 125 plus 0, it is still 125, and 125 minus 10, it is 115. So this is how we can find out the total utility. Now suppose these words are not there, and you will be asked what is this utility and what is this utility. Now if you look at all this number 50, 40, 25, all numbers are going down, and then it becomes 0, and then it becomes negative. Now the behavior of this kind of number is always found in marginal utility. And look at this number, it is 50, 90, 115, 125. So 50, 90, 115, 125, again 125 and 115. So it goes up and then it goes down. It happens only in total utility. So this is TU and this is MU. Now the MU is given and you have to find out the total utility. So starting point is 50, and then 50 plus 40 is how much? 90. 90 plus 25, it is 115. 115 plus 10, it is 125. 125 plus 0, it is still 125. 125 minus 10, it is 115. So from marginal utility, you know how to find out the total utility. Now here the total utility is given and then you are asked to find out the marginal utility. So starting point is 50, and then what, how much you can write here, so it will come to 80. So let's say 80 minus the previous one, that is 50, so that comes to 30. And then this is 100, so this is 100, and the previous one is 80 minus 80, so it is coming to 20. Then it is 110 minus 100, so it is 10. And then it is 110 minus 110, so 110 minus 110, so that comes to 0. And then it comes to 100 minus 110, so this is minus 10. So this is how you will find out the, when the total utility is given, how you are going to find out the marginal utility. So up to here we have finished the consumer behavior with DMU, that is diminishing marginal utility for one product. Now we are going to discuss about the consumer utility theory with respect to two or more than two products.